West Virginia, Blue Ridge Mountain, Shenandoah River. Life is old here, older than the trees, younger than the mountain, blowing like a breeze. Country roads take me home to the place where I belong. West Virginia, mountain mama, take me home. Country roads, all my memories gather round her. Miner's lady, stranger to blue water. Dark and dusty, painted on the sky. Mystic taste of moonshine, teardrop from my country road, take me home to the place where I belong. West Virginia, mountain mama, take me home, country road. I hear a voice in the morning, how she calls me. The radio reminds me of my home far away. Driving down the road, I get a feeling that I should have been home yesterday. Country road, take me home to the place where I belong. West Virginia, mountain mama, take me home. Country road, country road, take me home to the place where I belong. West Virginia, mountain mama, take me home. Country roads, take me home. Country roads, take me home. Down country roads.
All right. Our sponsors for the day. We have Amdreamo Music at amdreamo.com, working exclusively with the artists, helping them to take control of their music by building their fan base and getting them exposure all across the country, the world, using strategic collaborations. Remember, punks. No, y'all not punks. Y'all some sexy individuals. Remember, sexy individuals, okay? You may be sexy, but if no one can see you're sexy, then it's all in vain, okay? Remember that, all right? You need to get it out there. You make the best cookies in the world, but no one's eating your cookies, okay? That's why you need Amdreamo Music at amdreamo.com. Another thing I was thinking, some of y'all might not even know how to spell Amdreamo. So, it's AMDRIMO.com, baby. Soon to be an auto in your spell checks on your iPhones, okay? So, you can jack it up. Wait for the next update, okay? The next update, you'll be able to jack up Amdreamo in your iPhone, and it's going to correct it, okay? A-M-D-R-I-M-O. I know y'all can't spell bitches. Also brought to you by Butch Howell's Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu and MMA LLC. I want to take y'all back. This is before, I'm not even sure if this was before or after UFC 1. But me and a couple of my friends, we were walking down Harford. We're walking down Harford Road, right? So we're probably up at the top. So this is Baltimore. So y'all who know Baltimore, East Baltimore, you know what I'm talking about, right? I can't even think of the place. Like, it might be, I cannot think of that road. But there's like a main road, you know, up on Harford. Now, we're talking about Harford and North Avenue, past Harford and North Avenue. It's close to the school. Like, they had Lake Clifton High School was at the top, right? So you go all the way at the top, and then you bang that hard right hook, make that hard right, and then you can get to Lake Clifton High School, right? So we're talking about up that area. So we're walking down. Me and my homies, we got Jazz and maybe Chris and Steven. I'm not really sure, I know Jazz was there. That was one of my best friends. So he was there. I don't even know why we was up there. I can't even remember why. It was probably see a girl or something. But I don't remember any girls. Anyway, we're walking down. We get to Harford and... Oh, my memory. I'm old. Okay, I'm getting old. Harford and something, right? And this was a big gang back in the day. This is, we talking about street gangs. Like, now they got Bloods and Crips. You got Vice. You got the GDs and the Vice Lords and all kinds of stuff, right? You got gangs. I don't even know their names. But back in the day when I was a kid, it was street gangs, okay? We had a few. North and Bond, North Avenue and Bond Street. Those are two streets that cross. That was, you know, that was my little gang. That's where we hung at, right? But I'm just hanging with my friends. They're not a part of North and Bond. They're part of their own neighborhood gang, right? But we had alliances and friendships all throughout. So it didn't matter. Like, we weren't fighting each other. We were, you know, we was there for each other. So me and my friends were walking down Harford. We passed whatever high schools. We're walking down. We get to Harford, and I want to say it can't be Clifford, but it's one of these streets. Oh, that is, I'm upset that I can't remember it. But anyway, so we walk through this neighborhood, Harford Road and whatever, right? And then it's winter time. It's cold. And out of nowhere, I get hit with this snowball. I look like, yo, who's doing that, right? And I remember, hey, I'm with my friends. I'm not really with my fighters, you know? Like, these are just my friends, and I'm not trying to bring them into this, right? So I keep it moving, and maybe they could even throw another one at us. But, you know, we just kept it moving and got out of there. So I go back. North and Bond, how you want, Kerr? What's up? What's up? North and Bond, say how you want, Kerr? Oh, what's up? What's up? All right. Anyway, so that was a little bit of that Baltimore house music for you. All right, so I get the North and Bond. I'm like, yo, man, dudes from Harford and whatever. I swear, if I could remember it, I would say it. Like, it's not even a big deal. Because most of the people that I grew up with are dead or in jail or just scattered, you know? Like they're nowhere. Like, it's nobody coming up to me like, yo, you know? like that's just not happening. So, but I just can't remember that gang's name. But, you know, I'm like, yo, Harford and whatever. They hit me. They hit me with a snowball. You know, I'm probably like 13, 14. No, I'm not. I wasn't even in high school. So I was in middle school. So I'm 13. I'm either 12, 13. So they like, yo, for real? So we listening to, I want to say that it was, It was a Wu-Tang album. Like, I'm not sure if it was Gravediggers or if it was the first Method Man. I came to bring the pain, hardcore from the brain. Let's look inside my astral plane. Right? Wu-Tang. I know it was Wu-Tang. I don't know what album it was. I don't know who was out, right? I don't think it was Ray. I don't think it was Raekwon. It could have been, but I'm not sure. But he was definitely listening to some Wu-Tang. I want to say it was Meth, right? We listening to that, getting hype, right? Everybody, we just forming. We forming like Voltron, okay? We forming, I want to say we probably like, give us 10. It could have been more, right? It could have been like 10, 15 deep, right? We're going up the Harford Road. Now, we already know, like when I was little, like little kid, maybe 7, me and my dad, we were up at one of these check cashing places, and this Harford Road gang, like they were beating up like somebody. Like I want to say it was a lady, like some lady in her car, you know, she was just driving. Maybe they was beating up a guy. Maybe she tried to stop it or whatever. So then, you know, that's just bad. But like, don't do that. You couldn't do it back then. Don't do it today, especially in a rough city. Okay. Now here in Charleston, you can do that. Right. This is not the same environment. You see somebody getting beat up down here, you can say like, hey guys, chill out. You know what I mean? He had enough. But in Baltimore on Harford Road. Now see, even my gang, North and Bond, like we wouldn't have did that. Like if some lady, we had respect for women. We had respect for women, okay? We was not hitting women. We was not beating up women. But Harford Road and whatever, I wish I could remember y'all intersection. Y'all, somebody's listening, and they just saying, it's Harford Road and Lala Road, but I can't hear you. I'm sorry, buddy. I can't hear you. Anyway, so we listening to Wu-Tang, Killer Bees on a Swarm, right? Some people got that Mary J. Getting Right. I even tried it that day. That was my first and last time. Okay, so look, man, pass me that J. You know, of course it was blunts. Pass me that blunt. Fill it up with the Mary J. All right, so I'm in there. I'm ready to go. We're going to go up here. We're going to handle our business. All right, we get up there. Yo, who hit me with the ice ball? What? Yeah, you heard me. Who hit me with the ice ball? They pull out, some little kid comes out, right? He's little, like probably 10, 9, 8. 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. He comes out. I did it. What? Shorty, handle this, man. Handle this dude for me, right? Shorty is short, but he old. So that wasn't fair. And, you know, thinking back, like nah. Because Shorty was short, but nah, he was definitely old. You know, for us, he was probably like 12 or something. You know what I mean? Fighting some little 10-year-old, and we're not talking about like a big 10-year-old like Shaquille at 10 or LeBron at 10. Nah, we talking about freaking Bart Simpson at 10, you know. So Shorty, handle this for me. Then this other dude steps out, right? His name is David. He was like, yo, fight me. I'm like, what? Fight you? You hit me with the ice? He was like, nah, but fight me. You came up here to fight. I'm like, all right. Like, yo, come on, man. You know, and now at that time, my mouth was all over the place, okay? Now, it was crazy. So, you know, and you gotta hype yourself up. So I'm like, yo, it's whatever, man. He's like, all right, it's whatever. Now, we're in their neighborhood. We're in the heart of Harford Road and whatever. There's Harford and their crossing. This is their gang. We're in their territory. This is on the corner, right? This is like somebody coming to North and Bond ready to go, right? So already, one, that was a bad mistake. Like, you know, shouldn't have did that. Anyway, we square up. Now this is after Rocky IV, so I'm already ready. You know, I've been watching Rocky IV. I'm ready for this work, okay? Fire, strong desire, heaven in the air. Dan, 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 dan. I'm ready to go. Okay, Rocky defeated the Russian, the tall, towering Russian, then I know that I can defeat David. Okay? Now, David, we square up, right? I don't even remember any punches, but at some point, we lock up. All right? We lock up, and I go down. I'm on the bottom, and I'm taking that work. Like, I'm getting, like, it's not looking good for me, right? I'm holding him. It's in defense mode. Like, I'm getting roughed up. You feel me? Like I'm getting beat up. It's not Rocky IV. This is Rocky III. The first fight with Cubber Lane, Mr. T. I pity the fool. It's the first fight. So I'm getting waxed. Right? Like I said, I grab him, lock up, and I'm on the bottom. Okay? Now, at that moment, I wish that I had Butch House and his Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu and MMA slash. Oh, it's Jiu-Jitsu and MMA. It's no slashes. It's just LLC of Charleston, West Virginia. West Virginia's largest gym, boxing, kickboxing, Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu, MMA, judo, and more. Just imagine what I could have done with some judo, even with some Jiu-Jitsu, right? I could have really put in that work. With that boxing, that kickboxing, ooh, the shin right behind the ear. I'm telling you, if you don't know, there's a lot of guys they have unrealistic goals about themselves, right? And all of that changes once you get hit in the nose a few times, okay? I learned the hard way, but luckily I was young. I was able to recover from that. I know to avoid that now, but if I would have had Butch House, Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu, and MMA, the largest black belt instructor in Charleston, West Virginia. Okay, he's not from Charleston, West Virginia, but like me, I'm not from Charleston, West Virginia, but we're here. Okay, now they offer high top level instruction. I can attest for that. Remember, adult and children's classes. I was a kid, I would have definitely benefited from this. All right, thinking back. Once we did the hands, let's say afterwards, we didn't, whatever happened in the exchange, I don't really remember getting popped. You know, usually in my fights, I remember getting hit, but I don't remember getting hit from him. So maybe once we locked up, somehow, some way, he was just stronger than me. And I was just on the bottom. Now, at that moment, once I was on the bottom, that's when their whole gang heard that young David was fighting, right? The whole gang heard. Now, like I said, it was probably like 15 of us, and they just swarmed us, and all 15 of us got jumped. We called it bank, like back then. That's what you called it. Yo, I got banked, right? Now, we did our fair share of banking when I was a kid, so, you know, what goes around comes around. Or, as I like to say, what comes around. Like, you know, it don't even have to go around. It's coming around. Like, look, man, that's just the way it is. You could be as sweet as can be, but, you know, the wolves are coming for you. You know, you live with the wolves, you're bound to get ate. Anyway, we all got jumped. And looking back, I wish that I had some Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu, okay, to fall back on. If I had the internet back then, I would have went to www.advancedbkj.com. For y'all who can't spell, advancedbkj.com, baby. Okay? Learn from my mistake. My mistake was even engaging in that. I should have ate those Scooby snacks, okay? That ice sheet. That little snowball, I should have ate that. Bow. Nah, I'm going to just go home and play some Street Fighter 2. Who was a monster? Me. I was one of the best in Baltimore. I'm going to say it right here in the podcast. What? I was one of the best, if not the best. All right? What do y'all know about that Street Fighter 2 work? That's what I should have did, but I didn't. If I would have had Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu, I would have known, like, hey, you need to just take the L. Go ahead, fall back, avoid it, and wait for situations where you can't avoid it and no more. All right, another sponsor. Y'all heard me open up with Country Roads, right? So that was me on the guitar. Now, the last time you heard me, I couldn't play the guitar. Like, we had Garrett on the show, I couldn't play. But Fit Lou, hooked me up and hooked me up with a guitar, and then I started learning. Now, all the stuff that I did, I just went online. I just went on YouTube and typed in the chords, like, because I understand music. I just don't know how to play these chords on the guitar, right? So I figured that out. Now, it still could be better, like, you know. But there's always room for growth. And that growth, get your growth at BoKnowsMusic.com. Bo Knows Music. Do-do-do-do-do. Anyway, cue the music.
Let me introduce you to Bo Miles, a unique and likable guy. Everyday life, friends and family makes up the artistry.
All right, here we go. Back at it again. In the devil's mouth. In the bull's sternum. Whatever you want to call it. We got a few chords, right? Now, the whole idea of this one is going to be songwriting. Now, what's going on right now? We're talking about the Baltimore riots, the Baltimore uprising, like whatever, however you want to call it, right? Now, I'm not in the city. I'm an outsider. I've been away from the city for so long. Like, it's like I'm not even from Baltimore anymore. It's just still in me. Like, I remember home. You feel me? I don't even talk like I'm from Baltimore. And I know that every time I hear, like, even with the news exposed it, because I hear people talking. And when you can hear somebody and tell that they got an accent, that means that you don't sound like that. Now, you know, when I was in Baltimore, I never, ever felt like somebody had an accent, right? So I lost mine, you know, unfortunately. Like I said earlier, most of the majority of my friends are dead or locked. It's kind of cliche. Like, that's the, yeah, but I'm not even going to focus on that. I just don't know where they are, okay? The majority of my friends, I don't know where they are. My family, I only have like I have a small family far as my mom and her sisters and brother. Like we were really just a small unit. So, like, I see them on Facebook, you know. Well, I'm going to try to get to see my grandmother this summer. So I'm going to see them, you feel me? But that is small. Like, I can count them on, I would say, two hands. But I'm sure, like, and I, you know, I got some other cousins and I got friends and family. But it's a small number compared to, like, you know, what little bit I got now, which is still like I'm an outsider here, you know, because like I lost my Baltimore accent, but I don't have like the Charleston accent, because when I hear people talk from here, I can still be like, yo, you know what I mean? You got an accent, but it's good. It's no problem. It just means that I'm just in limbo somewhere, right? So I'm in limbo, and we got the Freddie Gray uprising going on, you know. So dude gets arrested and he complaining about problems, and you know, it's just not looking good for him. And by the time he gets to his destination, he's unresponsive, and then later on they pronounce him that he's dead, you know. Now this is a bad situation, and I hear people, like, just at work, because y'all know I'm a teacher. So I hear people at work and they talking a bunch of nonsense. Like, you don't even understand what's going on. Like, you don't even understand the climate of the people. All right. Like, what we need is more compassion, because nobody wants to be a failure. Like, you got to remember that. Like, nobody wants to be a failure. No kid is like, you know what, man, when I grow up, I'm going to be a failure. Like, yo, I'm trying to be a failure. That's what I'm trying to do. No kid starts off like that, okay? So just quit even thinking it, all right? What happens is that eventually you get in school. At some point, you're not making the grade. You're failing. No one wants to be a failure, but you got to keep playing the game. Like, yo, nobody going to want to keep playing the game if they failing. So eventually, you either going to pull out or you're just going to figure out some other way. It is what it is. That's just the truth. No one wants to keep failing at something. And especially when you're a kid, you don't even know how to even get better. Now, if you're an adult, yeah, you have some type of idea. Hey, I can, you know, put in the work, do this, do that. And then y'all like, oh, it falls back on the parents. It's up to the parents to la, 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 blah, blah, blah. Like, yo, I'm a parent, okay? I do not control my kids' every thinking, just all their thinking all the time, okay? I stress the importance of education, but that's not good enough in the sense that we're all people. And as a person, you have to make the decision for yourself. Now, when you're a kid, and we're talking, when I say kid, I'm talking like 5, 6, 7, okay? So that's when they're learning like, yo, man, I suck at school. They're not learning this stuff at like 10, 12, 13. At that point, it's pretty much a wrap. You got a 13-year-old kid who suck at school. I mean, unless you, and what it takes is that you need to get in there, in their classrooms every day and get them on the right track. Because I see adults who not doing what they're supposed to do, who set up whatever. They set up little minor goals. They set up small goals for themselves, and they don't fall through. They don't follow through, I'll say. They fall through, and they're back in the same routine. We can just look at weight loss, which is a big issue in adult culture. Weight loss. So many people trying to lose weight. So many people start, look, I'm going to start this new year. I'm going to lose 10 pounds. I'm going to lose 20 pounds. We're talking about 20 pounds, okay? You weigh 200 and whatever. You weigh 100 and whatever. You weigh 300 and whatever. We're talking about 20 pounds. 20 pounds is hard to lose. Like, the discipline that it takes to lose 20 pounds is not like, yo, it's a cake. But you look at those numbers, and we just say numbers. Yeah, of course. Oh, man, that's easy. No, it's not easy. All right, 20 pounds is not easy. Yeah, the number 200, and you just say, all right, let's count from 1 to 200, and then let's subtract 20. Yeah, that sounds easy. 20, you know, from 200, yeah, that's small. Like, if you want to lose 100 pounds, that seems a lot harder than 20 pounds. And then, hey, let's just lose 10 pounds. But look, it's hard. So now, if we keep that in mind, that it's hard to lose 20 pounds, then when you're a kid, it doesn't matter. 6 all the way up to 18 is going to be hard to change your routine, because that's the thing that you have to do to lose weight. You have to change your routine. All right. And it's hard to do that once you fall into a routine of whatever it is. And then you got genetics fighting against you. You know, a lot of y'all skinny people, y'all got genetics on you, just helping you out, you know. But that fat is still in you. Like, trust me, you know, it's only a matter of time. Like, it's only a matter of time before, you know, whatever sprouts up. And it's like, oh, where did that come from? Like, look, man, it is what it is. So we can't blame the parents. And we have to put responsibility on the youth. But at the same time, you can't put, you know, 100% of responsibility. It's just a hard task, you know. And I say that because with this, you know, because I hear people always complaining about, well, you know, they should do this or they should do that. At the end of the day, you don't know jack, okay? I don't know jack. I don't know, all right? So I'm not going to speak on something that I don't know, especially condemning somebody. Like, yeah, I'm going to speak on it, and I don't know. All right, yeah, that's what we do. We have English. We talk, all right? But I'm not going to condemn somebody if I don't know the story, because I do know that no one wants to be a failure. Everyone wants to be successful. All right. Now, when we get to Freddie, I don't know his background. Right. Freddie's not even the first one. Like, it's just a epidemic of cops, you know, just killing the young black youth. And if you keep digging, They kill people. Like, they kill white people, Mexicans, blacks, whatever. However you want to cut it and divide the races, you know. And the whole thing, I feel like we just have criminals. We have criminals for cops. Is it all cops? No. No. We got some good cops. Especially, I can say that here in Charleston, you know. But even here in Charleston, like, there was an incident where a cop was teaching his kid to say nigger, you know, like, she was probably, what, 7, let's give her a range of 3 to 7, right? And he's just getting her ready for nigger and all other type of offensive language, right? Now, I want to say that he lost his job, He lost his job for that. Was that right that he lost his job? Nah, I don't think so. You know, like, because we can't sit around and act like this stuff isn't real, because it is. It's always us versus them. If it's not black and white, or the Mexicans and blacks over on the West Coast, which I don't know if things got better, but, you know, at some point there was a tension over there, right? Then you have the Catholics versus the Protestants. You have people, you know, America, white America versus the Italians or the Irish. I mean, the Polish. It's always like, just, you know, that dance is here. So should you be held to maintain a lie? Because that's what it is. Like, if every day that you, okay, you haven't recorded, I don't have any recorded information on you feeling some type of way about any group of people, that's good. But you do feel that way. So why not? Let's be honest. Like, let's be honest. All right, is it right? No, it's not right. It's not right that I, you know, if, let's say, I feel some type of way about homosexuals, gay, like, I don't even know if it's called homosexuality anymore. I mean, I don't even hear it. You just, or maybe you do. Like, I just never pay attention. You know, the latest thing was dude getting, you know, transgender. Like, that's what I've been hearing lately. But, you know, whatever it is, right? You gay or you homosexual, whatever. Like, if I feel some type of way about that, like if I, you know, hate you or I do something, is that right? No, it's not right. But if that feeling is there, that feeling is there. Like, I shouldn't lose my job. And that's the same way. Like, if a white person, they don't like black people. Look, they don't like black people. I'm not asking you to like black people. I'm just telling you, or it's just saying that, hey, man, treat people equally. You don't have to like them. You don't have to like them. But treat people equally. Treat people like, and that's what it's all about, okay? It's not about the word. It's about the action. Now, if I can't tell by the way you treat me whether you like me or not, then I, hey, that's good. That's good enough for me. Now, if I personally dig and find some stuff, you know, hey, man, that's that. Look, it doesn't matter. If I couldn't tell by your actions, then, hey, it doesn't matter. Is it right? No, it's not right. But a person and their feelings, they shouldn't lose their job just because they have a hard time pretending to like people, and we're going to reward somebody who can pretend. Like, come on. Like, that's ridiculous. That's ridiculous. Anyway, the whole idea is that, you know, the cops here are, you know, bad too. The cops are, and the issue that I feel is just an issue of power. Like, I like to go back. I like history, and that's something you guys will eventually, you know, you'll know, like, by my 100th episode, you'll be like, yeah, he likes history. Anyway, you got kings, and then you have the soldiers, right? Whatever they may be called, I can't even think of what they were called. But you have a king, and you have his soldiers, his foot soldiers, and they going through the town, and they just wrecking shop. They just do what they want, right? We can kind of think of Game of Thrones, and Game of Thrones is a good show in the sense that there is some reality to that. Now, a lot of it has been dramatized for TV, and that's great. It's some good drama. But the abuse of power is there. And that's really what that show represents, the abuse of power. And it is not color, because you barely see any blacks, right? It's just, look, the North versus this, and Westeros versus la la la, and, you know, this king and that queen and family and royalty. But the main idea is power and the abuse of. And that's what these cops fall into. And you have that type of, you have that there, that recipe for, hey, here you got some power. Somebody's going to abuse it, right? Somebody's going to abuse it. Now, back to the music, because I talk about this, because this is the type of stuff that's in the music, right? Just the feelings of the people will be articulated in the music. You will be able to find it. And as you can tell, I picked up the guitar a little bit and I learned a few chords. G, E minor, D, it could be a seventh, I don't know. D, C, and then, you know, back to G. So it's pretty much a 1-5, and Garrett talked about this on the episode, but I, you know, I couldn't play the guitar at that point. 5, and then 6-4, right? So
when the night shine, we'll shine together. You can man under my umbrella. You can stand under my underpin. I don't know the words, but I know the melody. In the sunshine, you'll shine forever. You can stand under my umbrella. You can stand under my umbrella. You can stand under my it's raining, raining. It's raining, raining. It's raining, raining. It's raining under my umbrella. Hey.
All right, so we have that progression, right? We have the events of just the Baltimore uprising, the Freddie Gray kickback, the lashback. You know, we're tired of this mess, and it's not even, this is not a black thing, okay? This is just America, and that's what people all over the country need to understand, is that, one, no kid wants to be a failure. No kid just wants to throw away their life and be on the losing team like that. No, no. Now, when you get older, yeah, let's say you've been winning the game. You're like, yo, man, I'm trying to make this thing harder for me. You know, I'm trying. Set up some handicaps. Maybe I can. I only can use just one hand, right? You doing that jiu-jitsu work? I'm only going to use one arm for this time, right? So, if that's your thing, all right. But that's not people, and I'm all people. I don't care where you're from in the world when you come to this country, or when you leave. Like even ISIS, right? Like. And to me, like, just how it's portrayed, like, man, that's just some brutal stuff. You know, I was watching, like, a beheading, which I try to limit my beheading views. I don't want to see too many beheadings just because, like, yo. But it was a clean beheading, right? So they beheaded some Christian. Now, the one, I was watching one of these Mexican beheadings. Oh, man, that was vicious. Like, I mean, it was just awful, you know, like it was like, I want to say it was with a chainsaw, right? And I mean, it was crazy. But this beheading over in Islamic town, this was real quick. The guy had a big sword in his head, you know, he had the guy bend over and the guy was trying to lift up. And eventually he just, I mean, just that quick, like, and his head was off, you know. That was a lot better than that Mexican cartel where you're getting a chainsaw hit to your neck because he got popped with his neck and then he just flew, you know. So I don't want to be too graphic, and sorry if, you know, if that kind of freaks you out, because that freaked me out too. Any, the whole point is, even them, like, they weren't, when they were little, you know, 3, 4, 5, they weren't like, yo, I'm trying to be a rebel, I want to kill people, I hate people, like, it's just not like that. I'm in the class, I'm in the front lines of education, okay, and I see these kids, and they're just some good kids, they're sweet kids, and I know that eventually, you know, whatever, life is gonna come, and they're gonna make choices, and it is what it is, but at those young ages, I mean, they're very, very sweet. Like, even I had a kid call me a nigger. He didn't call me a nigger, but he did say it. He was like, oh, because I was subbing for a school, and the kid walked in, and then he walked out, was like, oh, there's a nigger, you know. So I didn't even know. I didn't even hear it. And then later on, the girl told, she was like, yeah, he said a bad word. He called you a nigger. And I'm like, wow. And then by that day, like by the end of the day or whatever, or the second day there, like, dude, me and him was cool, you know? So, yeah, he was filled with whatever from his family or just from outside sources or just, you know, because he didn't know. I mean, he was just a little kid. But we was doing some math together and we bonded. And, you know, by the time I left there, like, even and that'll be gone. Like, that experience, you know, who knows how he's going to interpret life after that. But the whole idea is that no one starts off wanting to be a failure, wanting to do wrong, wanting to be bad. Like, no, that's just not how it works. Eventually, you get to that point, right? And I want to say that I wrote a song about that. But today, we are going to, well, me, you guys are going to listen to me. I'm going to write a song and take it into account, you know, just growing up in the whole Freddie Gray thing, right? So this is like a clinic on writing songs. Just one way. I mean, you could do whatever way you do. I mean, do it that way, you know. And if my way is different from your way, just keep doing it your way. My way is not right. It just works for me. This is usually how I do it. So I'm only going to work on the guitar. Now, normally when I do a song, I do it on the piano because I have more facility. I know it, you know. The piano is like my spouse. It's like my wife. So I know it inside and out, and I know what I want, and I can produce what I want through it, right? It's like me. It's an extension of myself. Now, this is an extension of myself, but this is more like a new person, maybe a new friend that you met at work, right? So that's how the guitar is to me, and I have a small vocabulary with my chords, whereas on the piano, like when we're talking about the 1, 5, 6, and then 4, right? I would have turnarounds on the 4, so I'd do like a 2-5-1 on the 4 and stuff like that. Again, if you don't know what I'm talking about, head on over to Bo Knows Music. Now, with that being said, like, you know, there's just a few stuff there on that Bo Knows Music, but you know, it'll be there. Like, it will develop. It will develop more. I will put more and more content on there. So just hang in there on that, on the Bo Knows Music. Keep going and just study the stuff that's up there because that's still good stuff, like diatonic chords, the circle of fifths, 2-5-1s, 1-4-7-3-6-2-5-1, like that type of turnaround. Like, that stuff will still get you right, still get you right. So anyway, there was a game that that we used to play as kids called, we used to play a few games. We used to play It's, and you just touch somebody and they're it, and then they have to, you know, they have to chase people, and then when they catch you, then you become it, and then you have to find somebody, you know, that's slower than you, right? So we did that. We did Catch One, Catch All, which was another, like a variation of It's, but it was more like a virus, I guess. It was teaching us about diseases where you touch a person. It was like, you know, we could have called it zombie apocalypse. You touch a person, you catch somebody, now they're on your team and they have to catch, you know, now it's two against whatever. And then you keep building until there's only one person left. And then the last person to get caught, you know, they pretty much win the game, right? So that was Catch One, Catch All. Another one was Cops and Robbers. Now, Cops and Robbers, that's the theme that I'm going to use for this song. Now, first thing I need to do is you should always tune your guitar, you know. So, now normally, now right now I have a tuner, but before I had the tuner, use YouTube. Like, you can hit tune guitar and then it will, like it'll be a video which just keeps playing it for you, and that way you know, like, okay, it's tuning, right? So now I have a little bit of rattling in there which I'm not sure why. One of you guys know why. So leave a comment. Like, let me know what's up with that rattling. What do I need to do to eliminate the rattle? Okay. All right, so we're just going to tune that. So that's good enough, right? So here we go. Let's turn this off. Save that battery. Okay, so I like to kind of play with the chords and see what melody. Now, the thing with me is I like phrasing before words. What does that mean? It's kind of let's think of the melody, right, for a particular section. Ba da da, ba da 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 da. So I'm gonna work with that. All right, so I had a melody. I have just a general idea of the melody. So let's see. All right, anyway, did I explain the cops and robbers game? All right. I'm all over the place. That's why I don't have too many listeners. I'm just kidding. I got great listeners. Thank you guys. Anyway, so for you those who do not know, cops and robbers. It's a game where, I guess that's like the foundation for a bunch of our hood games. I don't know what y'all call it in different parts of the world. But here in Baltimore, in the United States, that's what we played in the variation. So, cops and robbers. You have a team of cops, and they have to arrest the robbers, right? It's like you have to run, you know? Like, that's the thing. You see a cop, and we're talking about 7, you know, 5. This is just fun games that you play. And like I was saying with Jamie back at Jamie P on one of these episodes, we were saying how all of these things, you know, it's getting you ready. It's preparing you for something, you know. All our games, right? Cops and robbers. Just, you know, just that. I mean, that's... We play the game. No, I have to run away. All right, I'm gonna write that down. I don't know if I'm gonna use it in the end, but we'll just start there. All right, so we play the game. You know I have to run away. You know I have to run away. Now, this is just old. This is old school right here, okay? I just have a pen, paper, and the guitar, right? This is how John Lennon and Paul McCartney. I'm not even sure. I would have to read it. But just based off of memory, I can't think. This is how they wrote, you know. One had the pen, the other had the instrument. Play the game. You know I have to run away. I didn't write away. That makes a difference. Okay. We play the game. You know I have to run away. Keep that same phrase. Ba da da. da, da. Right, so we did play the game, no matter, run away, make it to base, then maybe I'll be safe. Let's see, make it to base, then I know that I'll be safe. How about that? Make it to base. Make it to base, then I know that I'll be safe. How about that? Then I know that I'll be safe. Then I know that I'll be safe for the day. Something like that. Let's try it. Play the game. You know I have to run away. Make it to base. Then I know that I'll be safe for the day. Let's see. We'll just do that, just that second part. Make it to base. Then I know that I'll be safe. You give chase. Now, this is basic, just because... We got bass and chase, you know, but you want to have some rhymes in there. You know, it just makes it a lot easier to learn some, you know, when you have rhymes in there. So let's see. I'm not really going to worry about, like, format. Like, I'm not going to count how many bars. I'm just going to run with what feels good. So let's see. Let's see. Play the game. You know I have to run away. Make it to base. Then I know that I'll be safe. And I'm gonna change it up. But how? Let me see. We're just cops and robbers. Let me see. We're just cops and robbers. Running through the streets, we're just cops and robbers. See who can see their family. Yeah, we'll just write that. Now, normally I would definitely spend more than whatever, like this time that I'm doing now. This is no time, like, just from the initial when I started to now, like, I would definitely spend more and more time refining and checking out and see what works. So we'll just write that down. Let's see. I have to go over it again because I probably forget, and you'll tell because I won't sing it the same.
We're just cops and robbers. Something, something, something.
Let's come up with a free, but I do like that.
We're just cops and robbers. Running down the city streets. We're just cops and robbers. Who will see their family? We're just cops and robbers. Running down the street. We're just cops and robbers. Who will see their family. We're just,
yes, I like that. We'll just run with that. All right, so we're just cops and robbers running down the street. Running down the street. We're just cops and robbers. We're just cops and robbers who will see their family, right? So, now that's advanced rhyming, because street and family, you know, like they don't really work, but just the way you sing it, you know, you can make it work. So, we're just cops. Now I'm going to just use little symbols there, cops and robbers. Who will see their family? Then I'll probably say tonight or something like that. We'll see how it works. Who will see their family? All right, let's try and see if I got it.
We're just cops and robbers running down the street. We're just cops and robbers who will see their family.
And then, yeah, then we'll just go to another verse. So, first verse was the robbers. So, first verse, robbers. Second verse will be the cops. We'll, you know, give them a chance to say something. Now, a lot of stuff is going to be cliche. Like, you know what I mean? It's just what it is. I mean, this is why I kind of stepped away from words. Because I feel like words, like language, the words themselves is just a tool to imprison people and to keep them restrained and to control people. Now, yes, there is good in language. Yes, because you look at what Martin Luther King Jr. and Martin Luther, well, just Martin Luther, but Martin Luther King Jr. and, you know, they were able to, you know, do great things with words. And talk about Gandhi and even Malcolm X. I mean, Hitler, right? It doesn't matter who you name. I mean, they were able to achieve great momentum with those words, right? And Louis Armstrong was able to create things with music, and Duke Ellington and Beethoven and Mozart and Bach, and we just keep going back, right? So, you know, I'm not saying that we shouldn't have words, but a lot of times words can't capture the true essence of the feeling. It's just a roundabout way, you know, and people can use that to manipulate and to control. So anyway, let's just start the second verse. So now, like I said, I'm gonna start trying to figure out, now I have to make a decision, how do I want the cops? You know, do I want like a bad cop? And so we have, in our culture, we like that, really. I mean, you think about games. Think about TV shows like The Shield. That was a good one back in the day about some bad cops. And I like them. Think about Breaking Bad with Walter White. I think that's his name. I just started watching that. So I'm on the second season. And, you know, so far, I mean, it seems like a good show. It is. It's a pretty good show. Walking Dead with my man Shane. Shane, you know, was a bad guy in a sense. And I like Shane. I think a lot of people like Shane. So that anti-hero is definitely something in our culture that we like. You know, that hero that's flawed. So I think I might go with that versus like a cop who's just a good, clean cop, you know, which there are some out there. And it's never as black and white, you know, as a song, but let's see what we can do. So, hopefully I didn't forget the melody, because normally when I do this, like I said, it takes a while, because you can forget, like, you do a song this quick, you can forget your melody quick. So hopefully I didn't forget the melody. Ba-da-da. Ba-da-da-da-da-da. Da-da-da. Let's see. We'll start off with we play the game. We play the game. You know I have to chase you. Make the rules. Only the rules can break you. Let's see how that works. Let's see. Now I got to look at this first, what I wrote down, to see, because I only gave just like, what, two frees in there. So let's see. Play the game. No, you have to. Wait, you know I have to chase you. We'll write it down. Play the game, you know I have to chase you. We played the game, you know. We played the game, you know I have to chase you. You know I have to chase you. All right, so. Like the little first line. Now, yeah, I was it could be like this, and we could throw like a little solo in there or something. Who knows? Anyway. Play the game. No, I have to chase you. Let me see then. Let's see. I like what I said, but I don't remember it clearly. So I know something like the rules, only the rules can break you. And I like that because, but I'm going to have to figure out how I can fit it in there because I don't remember what I said. But the whole idea is that, you know, it's really whatever it takes. Sometimes you have to bend. This is, you know, from the cop's perspective, like a anti-hero, you know. It's not as, you know, this situation with Freddie, it's not as cut and dry as that. It's not as black and white. But, you know, for the purposes of this song, you know, because I just can't sum it all up. But hopefully I can at least, you know, put an idea out there. This is an anti-hero. See, I'm trying to figure out how I can put only the rules can break you. Meaning, in that you're thinking, hey, is he talking to the robber, or is he talking to other cops? So maybe, you know, and I know because I'm writing it, but that is the question. Let's see. So let's see how can I fit that in there. Play the game. You know I have to chase you. Get away. Can't, all right, let's see. Can't get away. Only the rules can break you. Yeah, how about that? Can't get away, you know. Can't let you escape, or how about that? Can't escape. Can't escape. And see, yeah, I like that. Because now, with that in mind, you don't know who he's talking to. You know, with the Even both of them. Even both verses. You don't know if they're talking to, if the robber's talking to robbers, or if, you know, the robber's talking to cops, or if the cops are talking to robbers, or the cops is talking to cops. So, you can't escape. So if I say you can't escape, then you know that he's talking to the robber. Or, I mean, he still could be talking to a cop saying you can't escape. But we'll just say can't escape. You know, it could go either way, and we might change it. Can't escape. Only rules can break you. Hopefully I remember that chorus. I tell you, like, when doing stuff like this, it's hard to keep track of your melodies. Usually what I do, I'll use a tape recorder. But I didn't this time. Only. Because I'm always forgetting melodies. Only rules can break you. And usually the way it'll work is I'll just go with the new rule, like whatever the new melody, and you'll see if I forget if I forget this chorus melody. So here we go. We play the game. You know I have to chase you. Can't escape. Only rules can break you tonight. I just like tonight. Tonight. Only rules can break you. I'm not going to put tonight in there, but I do. I want to put tonight. And then we go to here. We're just caught. Robbers running down the street. See, as you can tell, I forgot the melody. Whatever it could have been. We're just caught robbers. Who will see the families? Ah, I cannot remember that melody, but the show must go on. So let me just put a new melody and we'll just have to just run with it. We're just caught in robbers running down the street. We're just caught in robbers. Who will see their family? Just come and robbers running down the streets. We're just cops and robbers. Who will see their family tonight? Tonight. All right, let's take it from the top. All right. Here we go. We played the game. You know I have to run away. Make it to bay. Then I know that I'll be safe. We're just cops and robbers running down the streets. We're just cops and robbers. See their family. We're just cops and robbers running down the streets. We're just cops and robbers.
see their family. We play the game. You know I have to chase you. Can't escape. Only rules can break you tonight. We're just cop and robbers running down the streets. We're just cops and robbers. Who will see their family? Just cops and robbers running down the streets. We're just cops and robbers. Who will see their family? We're just cops. Robbers running down the streets. We're just cops and robbers. Who will see their family tonight?
So there we go. Cops and robbers on the tunes. So with that being said, we will call an end to this one. Remember our sponsors, AmDreamo Music, where they work exclusively with artists, helping them to take control of their music by building their fan base. We also are brought to you by Butch Howell's Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu and MMA LLC, Charleston, West Virginia. Website is www.advancedbkj.com. Last but definitely not least, bowknowsmusic.com. Offering quality online music lessons all the time.